This morning our call to worship comes from Psalm 9, verses 1 and 2. I will give thanks to the Lord with my whole heart. I will recount all of your wonderful deeds. I will be glad and exult in you. I will sing praise to your name, O Most High. Let's stand as we sing our first hymn, We Gather Together.
Good morning. Are you there? Good morning.
Good morning.
There you are. We are glad you're here this morning. And you're probably wondering, why am I doing this? Pastor Jack and family have taken some time, and you can be seated, honey. Pastor Jack and family are away spending some time together and for Thanksgiving, and he asked me if I would step in, and I have. And it's been a lot of fun at our 9 o'clock service, and we're going to continue that and talking about Thanksgiving this morning. And I got a couple of announcements that I want to make. The first one is that our Wednesday night dinners resume this Wednesday. You'll want to call the church office before noon on Monday and let them know how many meals you'd like to have. And it's not just for you, not just for our church. It's for anyone who could benefit by having a hot meal. If you'd like to sign up for extra meals, you know, I don't have to wear this when I'm talking, do I? Sign up extra meals, pick them up, deliver to neighbors or shut-ins. That would be great. We're going to have this week baked spaghetti, salad, bread, and dessert. So be sure and call the church office before noon tomorrow on Monday and let her know how many meals you would like to have. They have another announcement concerning Habitat. Habitat for Humanity is having a dedication this afternoon at 2 o'clock at the, it's 1066 Charlie Stevens Road in Walnut Cove. It's finished. And so they're going to celebrate an open house for Bobby and Darlene Strickland. And so you want to come and celebrate that this afternoon at, yes, it is, this afternoon, Sunday, November 29th. I can't read today, apparently, at 2 o'clock. Did I say something different a while ago? I'm sure I did. 2 o'clock. And then did we have another announcement? Oh, Children's Church is meeting in the Fellowship Hall. But I think they're already out there, so Doug Rose is leading that for us this morning. Let's see here. So, this is fun. As I'm looking for the next thing, here we go. That's all of our announcements. I'm going to ask Anna if she'll come back and lead us in another worship song.
Stand as we sing our next hymn of thanksgiving. Come, ye thankful people, come.
Come, ye thankful.
Thank you. You may be seated.
Today is the first Sunday of Advent. Advent means coming, and in this season, we prepare for the coming of Jesus Christ. One of the ways we prepare for His coming is by making an Advent wreath and lighting its candles to remind us of God's promises that come true in Jesus, who was born in Bethlehem. The Advent wreath has four candles in a circle, with one larger white candle in the center. We'll light one new candle every Sunday between now and Christmas. On Christmas Eve, we will light the Christ candle, which is in the middle of the wreath. Today we light the first candle, the candle of peace. God created this world to be a good place to live, but now it's filled with sadness and hardship. Despite our sins, God promised the people of Israel that He would someday restore the joy of living in His good creation. Listen to the reading of His word from Isaiah 65, verses 17 through 25. Look, I am creating new heavens and a new earth, and no one will even think about the old ones anymore. Be glad, rejoice forever in my creation. And look, I will create Jerusalem as a place of happiness. Her people will be a source of joy. I will rejoice over Jerusalem and delight in my people. And the sound of weeping and crying will be heard in it no more. No longer will babies die when only a few days old. No longer will adults die before they have lived a full life. No longer will people be considered old at 100. Only the cursed will die that young. In those days, people will live in the houses they build and eat the fruit of their own vineyards. Unlike the past, invaders will not take their houses and confiscate their vineyards. For my people will live as long as trees, and my chosen ones will have time to enjoy their hard-won gains. They will not work in vain, and their children will not be doomed to misfortune. For they are people blessed by the Lord, and their children, too, will be blessed. I will answer them before they even call to me, while they are still talking about their needs. I will go ahead and answer their prayers. The wolf and the lamb will feed together. The lion will eat hay like a cow, but the snakes will eat dust. In those days, no one will be hurt or destroyed on my holy mountain. I, the Lord, have spoken. We light this first candle to remember that God gave us Jesus Christ and opened the door for us to His promised world of joy and peace. When Jesus was born, the angels announced, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward people with whom He is well pleased." Let's pray. Thank you, God, for the peace you give us. We ask that as we wait for all your promises to come true and for Christ to come again, that you would remain present with us. Help us today and every day to worship you, to hear your word, and to do your will by sharing your peace with each other. We ask this in the name of the one who was born in Bethlehem, who will come again in glory. Amen. I'm going to read our scripture today. It's from Colossians 3, verses 15 through 17. Colossians 3, verses 15 through 17. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts. Since as members of one body, you were called to peace, and be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Let's pray. Father, thank you that you've brought us here this morning, not only to fellowship, but to lift praises up to you, to worship you. Lord, thank you for allowing us that privilege to do that. Thank you for helping us to be obedient. Lord, I know there's a number of folks that are dealing with illnesses and sickness. I'm reminded of Junior George, who this morning had an issue with aspiration, Lord, and had to be provided additional treatment this morning. And I just pray that you would be with Kim and all of the family. Just care for them, that your will would be done. Father, for every person experiencing illness, sickness, Father, provide wisdom to the caregivers. Provide healing according to your will. And we give you the praise, whatever the outcome, Father. Lord, there are so many things going on all around us in our nation, in our world. Lord, our leaders need wisdom. Father, I pray that you would provide that wisdom and understanding. Lord, help us as we continue in our worship this morning in every part, in the word that's read, in the testimony that's shared, Father, in the praises that are sung. And we ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. I'm going to ask you just to remain seated. We're going to sing Worthy is the Lamb. Just sing it with me from your seats. Or you can say the words in your hearts as we sing it together. Worthy is the Lamb.
Thank you for the cross, Lord. Thank you for the price you for it.
Start again by rereading the scripture that I read a moment ago. This is from Colossians chapter 3, verses 15 through 17. Colossians 3, chapter 3, verse 15 through 17. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you were called to peace. And be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through Him. How can you be thankful in 2020? I mean, really, how can you be thankful in 2020? A worldwide pandemic has shut down the world, our country, our state, our town, and for almost 6 months, even our worship services were recorded ahead of time and online. My favorite, toilet paper became scarce. Cleaning supplies like Lysol and Clorox completely disappeared off the shelves for months. Traveling out of town, never mind out of state, became prohibited. Even beauty salons and barber shops closed. Not that I had to worry about that. But vacations were postponed or canceled. Parks and pools closed for the summer. Airlines started parking their aircraft, fleet of aircraft in the desert because there were not enough travelers. And resorts started offering huge discounts to anyone wanting a change of scenery for work and advertising it as workcations. So my question is, can you book 2 weeks at a mountain resort and deduct it as a legal business expense as remote work? Inquiring minds want to know. I tried, and to no avail at my place of work. They just didn't want to let me do that for whatever reason. But not everything is negative. While work and school transition to Google and Zoom, every working adult and school-aged child became experts in digital backgrounds. Now, digital backgrounds, that's that thing when you're looking at someone in the camera and what's going on behind them. So, in many, I saw the Millennium Falcon cockpit from Star Wars. I saw the beaches of Hawaii. And I even have a friend who created a digital background of his office. So, no matter where he's at, when he's on a Zoom call, you're looking at him and he's sitting in his office. Pretty cool. I think he might be looking into the workcation thing too. New terms and words started circulating this year too. These are terms that I had heard before, but I really hadn't paid much attention to. Terms like workforce planning. It's being used on a regular basis really to describe early retirement options, job furloughs, job reassignment. You know, job reassignment, that's where your employer asks you to do something else other than what you're typically assigned to do. And the owners are doing that so they can keep the doors of their businesses open. Even the coronavirus disease has had multiple terms associated with it. From SARS-CoV-2 to COVID-19 to Corona, and I've even heard some of the younger generation talk about the Rona. You better mask before you catch the Rona. Another example is the adjective virtual being tagged to everything. I mean almost everything. Virtual meetings, virtual chat, virtual shopping, that's called Amazon in case you weren't sure, virtual worship, virtual interviews, and my all-time favorite, Sean, virtual lunch and learn. So the real question is, how do I share my virtual grapes with you if I want you to share your virtual chocolate chips with me? That's really the question of the hour. But you know, not everything this year has been about COVID-19. I don't want us to forget about the hurricanes of 2020, right? There have been so many storms that the people naming the storms ran out of letters in the alphabet. And the National Hurricane Center had to start using the Greek alphabet. 30 tropical storms have been named. And Tropical Storm Zeta came right over the Carolinas with wind, torrential rain, downpours, flash floods. But really, it was a welcome distraction. Because for the first time in over 6 months, COVID was not mentioned, type chatted, or talked about for an entire day. What a blessing. A colleague at work shared in a meeting that after much thought and consideration, she would not be observing daylight savings on November 1st. Now, the whole thing about daylight savings is you're going to add an hour to your day, right? Extra hour of sleep. She decided she is not going to observe daylight savings on November 1st because with the kind of year that she has had, she has not given 2020 one more hour of her life. I resemble that statement. So the question, how can you be thankful in 2020? Or maybe asked another way, what would keep you from being thankful in 2020? Gratitude or giving thanks to God is a form of worship. The concept of thanks comes up in the Old Testament 102 times, and the Hebrew word, yada, is used 72 of those times. It means acknowledging what is right about God in praise and thanksgiving. Thankfulness comes up 71 times in the New Testament, mostly related to the Greek word euharisteo, and defined to show oneself grateful, to be thankful, to give thanks. Looking at our scripture today again, Colossians 3:15, let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you were called to peace, and be thankful. So what would keep you from being thankful in 2020? The writer of Hebrews wrote it this way. See to it, brothers and sisters, that none of you has a sinful, unbelieving heart that turns away from the living God, but encourage one another daily as long as it is called today, so that none of you may be hardened by sin's deceitfulness.
Sing it with me. Praises rising, eyes are turning to you. We turn to you. Hope is stirring, hearts are yearning for you. We long for you. When we see you, we find strength to face the day. your presence, all our fears are washed away. Washed away. Worthy of all our praises. Hosanna, Hosanna, come have your way among us. Welcome you here, Lord Jesus. Hear the sound of hearts turning to you. We turn to you. In your kingdom, broken lives are made new. You make us new. 'Cause when we see you, we find strength. Your presence, all our fears are washed away, washed away. Hosanna, Hosanna, you are the God who saves us, worthy of all our praises. Hosanna. Welcome you here, Lord Jesus. 'Cause when we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away, washed away. Worthy of all our praises. Hosanna, Hosanna, come have your way among us. We welcome you here, Lord Jesus. Hosanna, Hosanna.
As we close, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.